video, we're going to learn to calculate the distance between two parallel lines. Before we get into that, I'd just like to talk about this issue of the lines being parallel and see if we really need them to be parallel lines. In other words, can we calculate the distance between two lines that are not parallel? I'm going to put the idea of skew lines aside for a minute because skew lines always bring in three dimensions, and we're really not working in three dimensions at this level. So what other kinds of lines do we have in a coordinate plane other than parallel lines? Hopefully you're thinking of two other categories. One is perpendicular lines. And then plain old intersecting lines, neither parallel nor perpendicular, such as these. Let's just ask the question real quick. Does it make sense to even wonder about the distance between these two lines or between these two lines? The answer has to be no. These lines intersect. They don't have any distance between them. Now, there's distance between certain points on two lines, even if they intersect. But if two lines intersect, there's no sense talking about the distance between. It's not really a logical inquiry. And so we don't make it. We only talk about the distance between lines when the lines are parallel. And the reason for that is because we can have a nice logical conversation here. Since the distance between these lines is fixed for their entire length, no matter where we go, we'll find the distance is the same exact value. The second thing we need to be aware of is that when I talk about the distance between two lines, I'm talking about the perpendicular distance. If I handed you this ruler and said, hey, do me a favor, measure the distance between these two lines, you probably wouldn't come up and do it this way and say, well, it's 8 inches because the distance from here to here is 8 inches. You could do that, but it wouldn't be a very useful way of measuring because everyone who walks up with a ruler would probably measure at a different angle. Someone else might say, no, it's 4 inches, actually. And then someone else might say, no, it's 2.5, and so forth and so on. So how do we measure the distance between two lines that are parallel? We always measure along a perpendicular segment, such as that one right there. That's the distance between them. And it really makes the most sense in practice. Let's look at a quick example. This one's pretty straightforward. It's a pretty simple problem. It says, find the distance between x equals 3 and x equals negative 5. And I just like to use it to make sure we at least understand the concepts involved, even if we haven't addressed the math fully yet. So to do that, let's look at these two lines in the coordinate plane, x equals 3 and x equals negative 5. The line x equals 3 is actually a vertical line, and we find that it's 3 units to the right of the y-axis. This is the y-axis, and this is the x-axis. And the line x equals 3 is actually that is the line x equals 3. And you'll notice anywhere on that line, the x value is 3 units. The line x equals negative 5 is back to the left, right around here. That's the line x equals negative 5. And we want to answer the question, what's the distance between them? In this particular problem, since these are both vertical lines, the distance between them will be measured along a horizontal segment. And I think the easiest place is to do that on the x-axis. Graphically, we can simply count. This is 5 units here. This is 3 units here. So the distance between them is 8 units. 8 units. Unfortunately for us, not all lines that are parallel in the coordinate plane happen to be vertical or horizontal. And so sometimes we actually have to run the math. So let's take a look at that in a different example and see how we do this algebraically. First thing you should notice is that the slope is the same. And it has to be. If the slope were different, then they wouldn't be parallel lines. And there'd be no sense asking the question, what's the distance between them? But since they are parallel lines, we can look at that. I'm just going to put them in the coordinate plane over here so we can at least get a sense of what we're looking at. And again, this is just a sketch. It's not intended to answer the question. It's just intended to get us started, get a mental picture of it. Y equals 2x plus 4. There's my y-intercept of 4. And the slope is 2, so that would be up 2 over 1, something like this. And the other one is y equals 2x minus 1, so that would be down here for my y-intercept. And of course, that is a parallel line, so it looks something like this. Those are my two lines. And we're interested in knowing the distance, the perpendicular distance between them. Okay. So if we can find the coordinates of that point right there, and that point right there, I'll call them points A and B. If we can find those two coordinates, then we'll be able to put them into the distance formula and actually get a determination as to the distance. Notice I've chosen this point A as the y-intercept of one of the equations. I didn't have to do that. I could have chosen any of the infinite number of segments that go between these two lines, and any of them would have worked fine. But this segment is a little bit easier because one of the points I already know, that is the point 0, 4, that's point A, and that makes it a little faster to find point B. So the question becomes, how do I find point B? The first thing I need to do is find the equation of line AB, that is the equation of this perpendicular segment. So how do we do that? Well, we know it's perpendicular to this line, so therefore it must have a perpendicular slope. So the slope will be equal to -1/2. That's the slope of segment AB or line AB. The next thing I know about this particular line is that it passes through the point 0, 4. And so with those two pieces of information, I can plug it into point slope form of a linear equation, and I can obtain the other information that I need. So how do we do that? Y minus y1 is equal to m times x minus x1. That's the slope, the point slope form of a linear equation. So y minus 4 is equal to -1/2 times x minus 0. Now you'll notice that 0 is actually pretty convenient. It just sort of goes away. 1/2 times 0 is nothing. It's the other reason I use this y-intercept, because I like that 0. It makes my math calculations a little bit faster and easier. And that's perfectly fine. Let's simplify this. Y minus 4 equals -1/2 x. Add 4 to both sides. Y equals -1/2 x plus 4. So that is the equation of line AB. And I'll just write that right here. Line AB, the equation of line AB is y equals -1/2 x plus 4. Now, I already know the equation of this line over here. That's y equals 2x minus 1. And the equation of line AB is y equals -1/2 x plus 4. Now, to find point B, we simply need to solve the system of equations that is defined by this line, y equals 2x minus 1. And line AB, which is y equals -1/2 x plus 4. If we solve that system of equations, we'll have the common solution, point B. So let's do that. Let's take 2x minus 1 and set that equal to -1/2 x plus 4. I'll add a half x to each side. Those will cancel. This turns into 2 1/2 x minus 1 equals 4. Add 1 to each side. Those cancel. 2.5x equals 5. Divide by 2.5 on each side. X is equal to 2. That's my x value of point B. Now, to find the y value, I simply take my x value and replace it into either one of these equations. This one or this one. We'll use this one up here. So y equals 2 times x, which is 2, minus 1. Therefore, y equals 4 minus 1, y equals 3. So the value, the coordinate value of point B is 2, 3. Okay, now that we know the coordinates of B, and of course we know the coordinates of A, we can use the distance formula to calculate the distance between the two lines. So the distance formula looks like this. Square root of x2 minus x1. Squared plus y2 minus y1 squared. D is equal to the square root of 4 plus 1. Therefore, D equals the square root of 5. Now, this is left in simplest radical form, but of course, on a calculator, you can simply put in the square root of 5 and you get an answer. It tells what that value is. So that's how we find the distance between two parallel lines. It would not be a bad idea to reduce this process down into a discrete number of steps, which I'll do now on the board. Okay, these are the 5 steps needed to find the distance between two parallel lines. First, identify the y-intercept of the first line, that is This will be called point A. The y-intercept should be pretty obvious in the equation itself. 2, identify the slope of the perpendicular line segment. Remember, opposite reciprocals. Number 3, find the equation of the perpendicular line. You're going to use the point coordinates from point A and the slope you identified in step 2 in order to find the equation. Use point-slope form. Step number 4, solve the system of equations using the second given equation and the equation from step 3, and you'll label that solution point B, and then use the distance formula to find the distance from A to B. Okay, let's look at this example. I'd like to find the distance between these two parallel lines, y equals negative 1/3 x plus 7, and y equals negative 1/3 x minus 3. Notice they have the same slope, and in fact, they have to have the same slope if they're parallel lines. So, step number 1 was to find the y-intercept of the first equation, and I think you can see it's 7, and that means that the coordinates of the y-intercept are actually 0, 7. So that's step number 1. We've just identified the coordinates of the y-intercept of the first equation. Step number 2 is to find the perpendicular slope. And the slope here is negative 1/3, so the perpendicular slope is positive 3. Step number 3 is to use this slope and this point to find the equation of that perpendicular line in which we'll find the distance. So to do that, y minus 7 is equal to 3 times x minus 0. We need to simplify this just so it's a little easier to work on. Y minus 7 equals 3x. The distribution 3 times 0 becomes irrelevant since that's equal to 0. And now we can add 7 to both sides. And we end up with y equals 3x plus 7. That's the equation of my perpendicular line along which we'll measure the distance between these two parallel lines. Step number 4, solve the system of equations using this second equation and this new equation that we found in step 3. So negative 1/3 x minus 3 is equal to 3x plus 7. I will add 3 to both sides. We end up with negative 1/3 x is equal to 3x plus 10. Now subtract 3x from each side. Here, these cancel. On the left side, we have negative 1/3 x minus 3x, so that's negative 3 1/3. I'd like to write that as an improper fraction because it's a little easier to do the math on it. So this 3x is actually the same as 9/3 x. And then we add in another third, that's negative 10/3 x is equal to 10. We'll multiply by the reciprocal, negative 3/10. And we find that 10 times negative 3/10 is simply negative 3. So x equals negative. That's the x value. We now need to find the y value. Continuing over here, to find the y value, we'll say that y equals negative 1/3 times negative 3 minus 3. So negative times a negative is a positive. 1/3 times 3 is 1 minus 3. Y equals negative 2. So I have my x coordinate and my y coordinate. Therefore, the point I'm looking for is negative 3. Negative 3, negative 2. Finally, we use the distance formula. So step number 5. Distance is equal to the square root of the difference between my x values. Negative 3 minus 0 squared plus negative 2 minus 7 squared. Distance is equal to the square root. Negative 3 minus 0 is negative 3. Squared is positive 9. And negative 2 minus 7 is negative 9 squared, so 1. Therefore, my distance is equal to the square root of 9. As always, if you have any questions, please send me an email.